with Ms. Naomi King and all those members and all those who are participating in all the events that we're doing. Continue to be with us, stand by us, lead us and guide us in the way that we should go. It is in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Reverend. We got to start with God because we always put God in the center of everything that we do.
Absolutely.
Yes. Thank you so much. Well, I would like to welcome every one of you to this special meeting. As you know, that one of the reasons why we're calling the meeting is to kind of update you on what's going on with AD King Foundation and to always carry you along. And the second reason is because of the major activity, which is November 14, where we're going to definitely celebrate our 11th annual gala. But this time it's going to be very special. It's going to be virtual. Although the two people that we're going to be honoring, we're going to honor Reverend Brinstein, Paul Brinstein. And you know, Reverend Brinstein has been with the organization since inception. And I'm glad that in the past we've honored those that have gone, like, you know, Dr. Lowry and so on and so forth. So we feel that we need to give them their flowers when they're still alive. So we're glad that we honored last year, Ms. Dr. Faris. And this year, of course, Reverend Brinstein was a co-pastor with Reverend A.D. King and has remained a close family friend to Naomi and to the rest of the King family and has become a steward of telling the story about the legacy of all the brothers and the King family. So we feel that it's dearly time for us, without much ado, to recognize him and to thank him for his support over the years, as well as for him to continue to pass the baton down to the next generation and telling the story about the civil rights movement and how it has transformed lives. As you will know that the civil rights movement is about transforming lives and also building a beloved community. Many people don't really understand what a beloved community means. It means building God's kingdom on earth. You know, because we know God is love, and therefore when you build a community of love, you are actually following God's commandment and becoming, for lack of better words, a steward of God's kingdom on earth. We have to be witness, and we shouldn't be ashamed of our faith, because you know that faith is substance, is a substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. So we trust in God that everything that we put before him will come to reality, and his blessing and his mercy comes every morning. So knowing that, we know nothing is impossible through him.
Well, I'm on a call.
So that is our motto. And so I'm very grateful to all of you for the role that you play. Because you could have been somewhere else, but you decided.
Okay, well, I can't help it. Right now, I've got to be on here. I'll try to turn it down, but
I appreciate that. Yeah. Can you mute your mic?
Really, I don't hear things very loud.
Let me see if I can do that. Please mute your mic if you're not speaking, please. Let me see if I can do that. Hold on. Okay, please, thank you. Everybody meet. Okay, this year has been, I would say, nothing but a wonderful year. We've lost so many of our full soldiers, such as Dr. Lowry, City Vivian, John Lewis, and a host of others. And so this year, we'll always remember. But for those of us whose God has kept by his mercy, we need to continue to give him praise and to ask for is protection over us, because we know we only live by grace. Not that those that have gone before us now have done anything wrong, but again, it is through his mercy that we continue to live, and so we must continue to serve him in truth and by love. So we started the year very well by taking some kids to Birmingham, and hopefully we'll be able to continue to do that and expand the program. And talking about Birmingham, just about 3 weeks ago, the house that was bombed in Birmingham was declared as part of the African American Civil Rights Network, which is basically meaning that it's now under the Park Service and will be preserved for life and will be taken over by the Park Service. And that was inaugurated or designated by the Secretary of State. And I'm going to show you that clip quickly. And State Representative Sharon Tick was there. And also Mr. Stone Street was there. Mrs. King, of course, gave a very nice speech. And the Secretary of State did the same thing. So it was a very honorable day, and in fact, an historic moment. So I'm just gonna play a little bit for you to hear the
I can't hear it, Dr. Babs. Are we supposed to be hearing it?
Oh, you can't hear?
I can't.
Yeah, you went blank for some reason. I don't know what happened.
Oh, you can't hear it?
Now we can, but I can't hear it. If you're playing something, I can't hear it. No.
Oh, okay. So you can't hear the video at all?
No.
Let me pause it. Can you hear the video or not?
No, I don't hear it either.
I hear your voice, but I don't hear any video.
Oh, wow. Okay. That's interesting. I thought, let me see what I need to do for that. Hold on 1 second. Okay, let me see now. Can you hear it now?
Yes. The African.
Can you hear it now?
Yes.
Okay.
The American Civil Rights Network was established to tell stories that are at risk of being forgotten. This home could have been torn down. Those stories could disappear. And those stories, in my belief, are what bring us together as a community and as a country. And today's actions ensure that the events that occurred here on May 11th, 1963 will never be forgotten, ever. That was the date a pair of bombs were detonated here. Reverend A.D. King and his wife Naomi and their five children were all present. And today we pay a tribute to the family who was at risk. We also honor a father, husband, brother, civil rights leader, and a reverend, and that's very significant. Others have talked about the specifics of what has happened here, but here is the reality from my perspective. He marched in Alabama. He led people in prayer. He brokered for peace. He preached nonviolence, goodwill, and peace towards all. His history is a quintessential American story. It's an incredible testament, the incredible testament to his life, in my opinion, is the changed world that between 1963 and today, which is incredibly significant. And the proof of his life lives on through his family, who are, in the words of Dr. Alveda King, a family of faith, hope, and love. This home and the people who dedicated themselves to preserving it are a powerful reminder of our shared striving towards a more perfect union and of the importance of tolerance and of safeguarding our history so those stories will never be forgotten. So thank you all so much. And I will step over here to designate the home in addition to the American Civil Rights Network. And if you ladies want to come up, you're welcome to. What a moment.
Okay, that's this by Secretary of State when he designated a home of the Parsonage.
So excuse me.
Historic center. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. And you can go to my Facebook and you can get other clips, but I just wanted to show you that, basically. Also, on the same website, let me see if I can go back. Okay. This is Mrs. King's
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
It is a pleasure to see each and every one of you. And I want you to know, as I know, that it is a blessing to live in God's world. It is not your world. It is God's world. It is an honor and a blessing to have the legacy of my late husband and champion, the Reverend Alfred Daniel Williams King, who was my Boaz, if you will. He was the love of my life. And A.D. King designated for inclusion as part of African American Civil Rights Network. Even the bombing of a home in Birmingham, Alabama, on May 11, 1963, could not deter the faith, hope, love, and courage A.D. exemplified throughout his lifetime. My family, the A.D. King Foundation, Mr. Omi Crockett and family, and all who knew and loved A.D. are very grateful to the Department of the Interior. God bless America and the entire one blood human race. I am Naomi Ruth Barber King, co-founder of the A.D. King Foundation. Thank you very much for being here.
Very good, very good. So it's not historic, it's not confirmed. They will now have the Parsonage designated as an historic landmark and part of the African American Civil Rights Network, meaning that it's going to be taken over by the National Park Service and preserved for eternity. I think that's a great work. We've been working on this for the past 10 years and finally we made it happen. To God be the glory. Okay. Let's see. Again, I also like to point out the event that took place this year in January by going to Birmingham and taking some kids with us. I think that was an historic moment, and we thank God that none of us got sick, because we did not realize that was a pandemic. We were in the middle of a pandemic that we did not even realize at that time. But again, I just want to share something with you. Just recently, we had a rally in downtown, and the rally was to help the young people to go to the polls and to realize the significance of election and for them to participate in this coming election on November 3rd. So we did have a rally downtown. Some of our members were present, and I want to thank all of you that joined in that demonstration. Thank you so much. I'm gonna go quickly to the, well, we're gonna talk about that later. Let me just go quickly. This was some of our Birmingham trip. We visited the, we visited the Rosa Park, and we visited the Birmingham Museum. I'm just gonna go through this quickly. Sorry. But the kids enjoy themselves. That's the most important thing. And they wrote an essay after they came back from the trip, so that they can reflect on what they learn and the experiences. And normally at the end, during our gala, we select two kids for award. But this year, we're only gonna select one kid for the award. And again, these are just some of the pictures. They are on the Facebook website, so that you can begin to see that it's not just about ourselves, but how we transform lives of the young people. So I'm gonna stop with this little, you can always go back to the Facebook website or to our website. They are all there. Okay, but it's a very historic moment. Very, very historic indeed. Because we want our kids to be aware, not only of what happened in the past, maybe the experience they gain will lead them into forming a better world. Yeah, so I'm going to leave that and go back to our agenda here. Again, one of the things we do is work with the police. We work with the Fulton County Police on community policing. Next year, by God's grace, with a new sheriff, we might be able to come with new programs. Another thing we are looking forward to is that how do we get engaged with those that are about to be released from jail and have to be put in halfway houses, so that we can meet them at their point of need and actually help them to, you know, get smoothly into the society seamlessly. I think that's a very good cause. And also to work with the district attorney and the solicitor general to expunge some of their records if they are nonviolent offenders. Because I know a lot of young people are just put in jail just because of the incarceration policies that needs to be changed. But meanwhile, how do we make a difference in their lives? We need to continue to do that. And so we have a very good relationship with both the Solicitor General in the Fulton County, as well as the new DA. And we are reaching out to both of them to work together with us. So this is a continual. And then not only that, for those of we would like to extend that beyond just Georgia, so that we can start forming relationship with other groups. And one of the things we're also doing as part of our program for next year.
You got on the way out? My pleasure meeting both. Yeah.
Hello, can you hear me?
This bump you because I'm coughing all day already, man. I've been good to see you here. Okay. You'll be well. Be in touch. I'll let you know what's going on.
Can you mute your mic, please?
We have all contact. We don't have
you. What I'll do, I got your telephone numbers. I'm going to call each of you right now. It'll be a 973 number and put Dick Freeman in there, okay? Yes, sir. I'm going to call you right now, each of you.
Who is that? Could you please mute your mic?
Oh, very sorry. Pardon the interruption.
No problem.
Will do.
Sure. Sorry about that. So we just talked about community policing. Another program that definitely would like to embrace next year in a new program has to do with training the police itself. We have a program now that we call training diversity. We call it diversity program. And that diversity program follows the principles of nonviolence and also the steps of nonviolence. And we are going to be training some people to be trainers as well. And definitely we that's going to be a big program we're going to embark upon next year. Unfortunately, we wanted to do a lot of that this year because of the pandemic and the physical distancing, they call it social distancing. It's almost impossible to implement that this year, but definitely by God's grace, next year, we will, you know, make sure that we do that. And that will be another way of raising funds for the foundation as well. Because one of the things that we don't beg for money, but we do use our skills in order to generate funds and use our innovation to do that as well. And we are very grateful to some of our sponsors that have sponsored over the past 10 years, going 11 years, and they're still very strong because our gala coming up this year is going to be totally funded. And so we're very grateful. But it's going to be different this year because we're only inviting just 25 people to come to the headquarters of the Ronald Blue Trust. And then we're going to connect it to YouTube, to Zoom, to all other social media. And the award, the recipients of the award is Reverend Brinstein and also Ms. Schapp, Snap, for the youth honoree. One of the young ladies that went with us and wrote a very, very, very compelling essay about her experience. That's the kind of thing that we like to do, continue to do, to motivate young people to know that they are the leaders of tomorrow and we can pass the baton to them and lead them in the right direction and well motivated to become the best it can be. And I'm very grateful to everybody that participated in that program. A lot of people did, and we can't do this alone. As you know, this is a voluntary organization. And what you guys have been doing is so marvelous, so marvelous. And I'm very grateful. And Ms. King is very grateful as well. And so all the board of directors are very grateful to you for everything that you do to support the foundation. Well, the first thing I'd like to do is let's first acknowledge those board members that have been with us for so long. I'm going to start with Reverend Ferguson. Introduce yourself briefly and just, you know, we appreciate you, just briefly.
Hello, my name is Stefan Ferguson. I'm just honored to be a part of the A.D. King Foundation and the work that they're doing. And I'm recently moved from Atlanta, so I'm living in Fayetteville, North Carolina. That's my hometown, so that's where I'm at now, but we're still continuing the work. I'm just glad to be here.
Yeah, great. You know, there's no boundary anymore. With the internet, we can make things happen no matter where you are. And you're a very valuable member of our foundation. Thank you so much. And also, Ms. Yolanda, are you there? Okay, let's, Dr. Joe Beasley?
Yeah.
Okay.
How are you, Dr.?
Yes. I'm wonderful. I'm wonderful. Dr. Beasley is not only been with us from the inception for the past 11 years, but, you know, believe me, I can't thank him enough for the good things that he has done, even to the extent of going to South Africa with us, going to Nigeria, and it's just very valuable director of the organization. Dr. Pisney, go ahead.
Appreciate you so much, Dr. Babb, and how is the First Lady has
Thank you. Can you please mute your mic?
Hold on.
Let me see if I can mute that person. Thank you. Dr. Bisse, go ahead. Please mute your sound, your mic. I have to mute everybody. Hold on 1 second. Okay. When I set it up next time, I'm going to make sure everybody's muted, and I'll just give the person speaking the right to speak, because we don't want any disruption. Okay, go ahead, Dr. Bisley.
There's a lot of music.
Is that music coming from you?
Okay, I'm so sorry, Dr. Babb. There's another phone.
Okay.
Okay, it's off now.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
Why, sir?
Well, I'm just honored to be asked to serve on the board honoring Reverend A.D. King, and we're so delighted to serve on behalf of Ms. Naomi King, who is a queen in her own right. And so whatever I can do, you know, to be helpful, I'm available to do whatever needs to be done that I can do.
Thank you, sir. We appreciate you so much. Okay. Let's see who's next. Trying to just give me a second. Miss Yolanda, can you? I know you are muted right now. Can you go ahead and speak? Can you unmute yourself? Hello, Miss Yolanda, can you unmute yourself? Okay, she's not there. Representative Sharon Teague. Okay, Ms. Yolanda, can you speak now? Representative Sharon Teague, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you now. Go ahead, please.
I'm having problems with my desktop, so you'll see my name twice on your screen. I text you earlier, but to let you know.
Okay, no problem. Go ahead and introduce yourself.
Everybody, I'm happy to be here. I've been listening. I saw the video. I'm really thankful to be a part, to be on the board. I look forward to doing some world-changing activity, helping other individuals wherever their need is that is in our realm. So thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Let's see, who else do we have? Representative Shannon Cheek, I think you're on. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you, yes, ma'am. Go ahead and introduce yourself. And Representative Sharon Springer has been with the foundation from inception. And she's one of our full soldiers, and definitely we appreciate her so much. We cannot do anything without people like her, who has made infallible contribution to the organization. And they still continue to make us proud. Thank you so much. We appreciate you. Go ahead and introduce yourself.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Babs. I'm Sharon Beasley-Teague, and I've been around for a minute. I'm just thankful to be able to serve, and I thank you all and Dr. Babs for allowing me to do that.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you. Bless you.
You're welcome. Ms. Ellison, can you introduce yourself?
Yes, I'm Debbie Ellison. I'm a newer board member. I'm just, I adore and love Mrs. King and Dr. Bath. I'm just so honored to be a board member. And of course, I'm here to do anything that you need me to do, Dr. Bath.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I appreciate you. Ms. Nancy Flakes, Ms. Johnson, can you unmute yourself?
Yes, thank you, Dr. Babs.
You're welcome, ma'am.
Thank you for inviting me. Just so really moved right now. We are in a fight for our lives.
Yes.
And we have to unify. So thank you for bringing us all together. I would like to share that we invite everybody on this call and the A.D. King Foundation to partner with the Urban League and a number of other organizations, NAACP, Millennial Civil Rights, the People's Agenda, and others on Saturday, the 24th. We will be rallying and transporting and marching to State Farm Arena for early voting.
Okay.
We welcome all support for that. I will send you the flyer on that
After
this call tomorrow. And, just really moved by all of the conversation and the work that everyone is doing. I'm just thank you all for every ounce, every step, every movement that each of us are making. This is our time. It is our time to say, no more.
Yes.
The lives of our people are at stake, our children and our grandchildren. So mobilizing the vote and holding our elected officials accountable thereafter, and just partnering with each other is critically important. I also would appreciate the opportunity to share that probably everyone on this call knows someone who is struggling financially, paying their rent or their mortgage, keeping a roof over their heads, food, reemployment, generating household income. Urban League, along with 23 other nonprofits, have been pulled together to deploy $19 million of rental, utility, and security deposit assistance for Atlanta residents. All they have to do is dial 211 to access that help. We are here. We love to collaborate. So we will, do whatever we are called upon to do. But on the 24th of October, next Saturday, we are pushing as many people as possible to the polls for early voting. This election cycle must be decisive for us to have any hope for a smooth transition of power. And so whatever way it goes. So thank you for convening us. Thank you for the work that A.D. King is doing. And so we're here to support. So just let us know our role, and we ask you to support our work as well.
I can tell you definitely we're going to do that. And I would like to get that information as soon as possible so that we can organize it together.
Absolutely.
You are doing a wonderful
job. Can we call on you to collaborate?
Oh, we'll definitely.
Add you as an organization. This
is a wonderful call.
And anyone else on the call, thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you, ma'am. All right. And I also see, Sister Brenda Davenport, are you there? You unmute yourself. Miss Brenda, has been from day one with the organization, from inception, and she's one of our greatest foot soldiers, and definitely one of the most trusted that Naomi King would always refer to. Anytime Miss King doesn't hear from Miss Brenda, it will always have Dr. Babb, how is she? Tell her to call me, you know, so she loves you so much. Miss Brenda, go ahead and introduce yourself.
Well, Dr. Babb, I really can't talk.
Okay.
Right now.
Okay.
But I just wanted to try to get in and just say hello.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. We're praying for you, and you know that we're with you in spirit.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you, Miss Brenda. Okay. Is there anyone, because I see some phones that do not have names. If I've not called on you and you're on, please introduce yourself. Hello. All right.
Is that me you're talking about?
Yes, go ahead. Coach McDermott, is that you?
last time I looked in the mirror, I think I was.
Okay, go ahead and introduce yourself, sir. Mr. McDermott has been a board member, also one of our foot soldiers, and we really appreciate him. And basically, he's the one leading the Naomi King Center, which basically we hope that you know, as soon as this pandemic, we need to jump on that immediately. But again, he's been working diligently to make sure that the creation of the Naomi King Center comes to fruition. So just go ahead and introduce yourself and tell us so far where we're on that project.
Well, actually big things are happening. So there's several corporations and individuals who are about to jump on board, but we'll be meeting about that, Dr. Babbs. But what I wanted to add real quick is a few years ago, maybe over three now, I guess it was, when you and I and Naomi went to Birmingham, and we went to the house, and Naomi took the time to literally walk me through that evening that happened. And it was a very surreal experience for me because Naomi was very tearful and, well, very just, but at the same time, very peaceful about it. But to hear her tell that story of what happened that evening was really something. I don't know how many things like that in my whole life that I have ever experienced, because of course we're talking about acts of hatred and terrorism, and the way she conveyed the story to me, it was just almost like an angel from God was talking to me about this horrible thing that had happened. And it was one of the most spiritual uplifting moments of my whole life. So I'm very proud to be a part of everything that involves Naomi and you, Dr. Babb. So I guess I'll leave it at that.
Okay, right? Thank you. Appreciate you. And is there anyone I left out that hasn't spoken that's still on this media? Can you please introduce yourself? Anyone else? Unmute yourself and introduce yourself. Okay. Another project I'd like to talk about is the book we are collaborating with Ms. Dr. Schumann on the corporate kit. And right now we've signed all the necessary documents and we've gotten lawyers and they've looked into all the modalities in terms of our protection. And that movie will soon be embarked upon. I'm sure we're moving at a very fast speed. In fact, there are two different movies that we're looking into right now. One is The Backyard Tribe, and the other one is The Corporate Kid. And the lawyers have signed all the necessary documentations. We're looking for directors, and some of them have already expressed interest. So I think it's going to become a reality, really. The next thing I want to talk about is Mrs. King's statue. One of our board members actually paid for the statue. And so we're going to be doing a tour of the statue with different, we're going to start, I believe, from either Apex Museum or the library downtown. And then eventually is going to be at its resting place. But one of the things we also want to embark upon at the same time is also A.D. King's statue, so that when it comes to the resting place, both of them will be there. And so that would tell the complete story of their, not only their struggle together in life, but also a legacy that will be preserved in one of those historic sites. So I think we're working diligently on that program right now. I was with Mr. Stone Street today to go see where we're going to have the gala. Believe me, it's so wonderful. It's so wonderful. What we want to do, we're going to give very limited invitation to just about 25 people because of physical distancing. And then we're going to stream it alive. We don't want to have any break in a gala. So that's why we're doing it that way. And we're also very conscious of the spread of the disease. So we want to be sure that it's safe and everybody there is very comfortable. And those who cannot attend can actually view it online, either through Twitter, WhatsApp, Facebook, or Zoom. All kinds of media streaming will be done. The screen we have there will accommodate up to 500 people. We can see 500 people on the screen because a very big screen owned by Blue Trust. So we just went to look at that setup today. But physically, the number of people that were there was about 25. And the room there will accommodate about 200 people. So there's enough social distancing. And so I think that's a good thing because we have to be conscious of our time, our moment, and to be sure that everyone is safe. Okay. Do I have any comments from anybody? And again, I would like to support Ms. Johnson's efforts for the 24th of this month to make sure that a lot of people are aware of voting and they participate in it. So whatever we can do, please let's join hands and do it together. And definitely something that as soon as I get the information, I'll pass it on to everybody. Okay. Any comments, any suggestions? This is the time for comments, suggestions, and concerns. Everybody's good? All right. Okay, we're gonna need, I'm gonna send out some requests in terms of the arrangement for the gala, and also in terms of the protocols. You know, it's gonna be attended by some of the corporate figures that will be invited by, that Mr. Stosur will invite from some of the corporate banks. And so that we can move towards next year with very supportive groups, especially financially. So we're very blessed that we continue to receive the support from the community. And there's nothing that we've embarked upon that we said we're going to do that God has not provided. So I think we're very grateful as far as that's concerned. Please, if anyone is online and has not said anything, I'd like to acknowledge that person, because not all the telephone lines I'm familiar with right now. But this is a time for comments, suggestions, and anything that you'd like to address.
This is Yolanda.
Okay.
All right, or question. Yes, you ma'am. Were breaking a little bit when you were talking about the anti-recidivism program to when people are being are you mainly dealing with adults, or are we going to also incorporate juveniles as well, because they really need that assistance as well? I assisted two sisters who had lost their mom, and they were both living in Section 8 housing, which, you know, they're really put at a disadvantage. A lot of the children that are aging out of the system, and children that are incarcerated, they end up with no way to get out. They get a small stipend, and then they're just let out into the world with like less than $1,000, maybe $200 at one time. I don't know what it is now. So that's my question.
Oh, definitely. Let's get together and see how we can design a program for them. Okay. And we can reach out to some of our corporate sponsors to see how they can also assist. So definitely it's one of the programs we'd like to embrace.
Okay, great.
Okay. Oh, one more thing. When Dr. King was killed April 4, 1968, following that Sunday, Eddie King delivered a speech that Dr. King was supposed to deliver that Sunday. And the title was, Why America May Go to Hell. I just got the unfortunately, before Mrs. Coretta King died, she had given me permission when I went to the King Center to look at all the videos. And at that time, the speech was marked with Eddie King's name, and it was on a reel, those old reel video, old reel. But recently, I've made a request to get that speech back, but it's not been located yet. But as I reached out through the internet and through some of my friends, we were able to get in touch with a gentleman that sent me the complete text of the speech. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to reach out to Reverend Ferguson to kind of voice over so that it can sound like AD and read the speech, just like Dr. King read it on that fateful day at Ebenezer. And during the gala, hopefully, we might be able to just play that soundbite so that people will know and feel the last speech that Dr. King could have given. We never had the opportunity to do so, but his brother delivered it eloquently. And I'd like to have that rendition. And I know no one else I will ever entrust to do it other than Reverend Ferguson. So Reverend Ferguson, you got to jump in your hands now. I send you the speech tonight.
All right.
Thank you. Yeah. Anything for the order that we can talk about? Go ahead.
I just had a question on, so the events that you're speaking about and the different initiatives, are they posted on the website?
Oh, definitely we will post them on the website. Yes, we will have a section there that you can look at activities.
Okay.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Any other questions? My wife was supposed to join through her phone, but I haven't seen her here, unless she's hiding somewhere.
I am here. I'm present.
Oh, really? Why are you so silent when I say you couldn't introduce yourself?
I was waiting for you to do that.
Okay, let me introduce my wife before I get into trouble. I could hear the sound of Mrs. Onabanjo, who keeps me in check all the time. And of course, without her, I don't know what I would have done. So I'm very grateful to God for having her in my life, and for it's like a treasure to me. And, you know, I really love her. Miss Onabanjo, can you introduce yourself now?
I am Mrs. Onabanjo.
Go ahead, we're listening.
Well, it's good to be here. And we're grateful to God for keeping us safe and for all the activities that are coming up. We just pray that God is going to be the center of it all. And also we're praying for those people that have been affected by the COVID-19 virus. We're just praying for them and those in the hospitals. And we just thank God for God being God himself, and praying for this gala that's coming up, that God is going to use it to bless as many people as possible. Thank you.
Thank you so much. All right. Again, I will send out information to all of you through the website, as well as through your individual email, for activities towards the election, especially the event coming up on the 24th. And if you have anything that you'd like to share with us, you can always send them to me or communicate through the website. You know, our website, you can actually send us messages and it comes to the email and we'll respond back to you. We want you to be very active and not just be a passive member. And I know most of you are very active anyway, because you call me and say, "Dr. Babs, can we do this? Can we do that?" I'm always very open to ideas, because we have to always be innovative, creative, and we're doing this not for ourselves, but for others. So with that spirit and God's love, we know that we are on the right track. And again, yeah. I can't express how much appreciated I am for your activities and for your involvement.
Babs.
Yes.
You forgot to mention that we are trying to feed the hungry the week before the gala.
Can you explain that, please, since you brought it up?
Okay, we are going to package food, and then we need to find out which area is very much in need, and then we are going to box some food and pass it along. I'm not sure exactly where we are going to meet. That's something that we're still working on, but we're trying to bless those who are less fortunate than us the week before we have the gala.
Thank you so much for bringing that up. And also, we're also partnering with FODAC. That's a company that provides wheelchair on all medical equipment for those who are in need without paying for them. So if you know someone in need of wheelchair or bed or any hospital equipment, please reach out to us, we can provide it to them. And also during Christmas, we're gonna be getting a lot of food that we're gonna be giving out to people who need them. And we have that relationship with FODAC. So please, if anyone is in need, and since I'm in education, if you have young people that want to come to college, encourage them to call me and see how we can get them to college, because education is the key to the future. Without much ado, I think we've come to the end of this wonderful meeting. And Ms. Yolanda, can you bless us with the closing prayers?
I'd be honored to, Dr. Babson. Thanks again for inviting me on the board. You and Mrs. O, I appreciate you both.
Thank you.
Gracious Father, we thank you for this wonderful day, despite the circumstances. As Mrs. O said, touch the families that have been turned upside down from this COVID-19. Repair the breach, Lord. Continue to guide us, bless us. Reach out and touch everyone on this call at the point of their need. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen.
Amen, amen. Thank you so much, everybody. Amen. Have a blessed day, and please, let's continue to serve God, because that is the foundation of organization. I love you guys. God bless.
Thank you, Dr. Babs. Yes. Night.
Okay. Thank you.
Good night, everybody.
Good night. Good night.
I gotta be out of here at 5:30.
Is that right?